Welcome to the tournament. 8 quizzes are match fit and ready to do battle on the run. But who will go the distance to become champion? And who's heading for an early bath? We're about to find out. Scott, and welcome to the tournament, a knockout game where general knowledge, quick thinking, and staying calm under pressure are vital if you want to win. Let's meet today's players.
I'm Val from Berkshire. Last time I fell at the first hurdle. This time I'm looking to go the distance.
I'm Kev, a teacher from Edinburgh. Once tried my hand at stand-up comedy, and if anyone thinks they can beat me today, joke's on them.
I'm Molly from Shrewsbury. I work in finance and today I'm looking to strike it rich.
I'm Masha from London. Last time I was a losing finalist. This time I'm determined victory will be mine.
I'm Craig from Newbury, originally from New Zealand. I love my cricket and I'm planning on hitting everyone else for 6 today.
I'm Paula, originally from Derry. I play rugby and today I'm looking to drop kick all my opponents into touch.
I'm Kat. I work in a cafe in Cambridgeshire. I love singing in my choir, so here's hoping I'm going to be singing when I'm winning.
I'm Jeff from Wigan. I'm a sewerage works technician and I'm looking to flush everyone else out of the competition.
Welcome, everyone. I love it when everyone in the room is hungry for a win. Let me go to Kat over here. Welcome.
Thank you.
Kat, tell me about yourself.
I live in Cambridgeshire. I'm a front of house manager in a cafe. I love singing, I love theatre. Yeah. And quizzes.
So you're hoping for a standing ovation today?
Well, here's hoping.
Kev, you didn't reach your full potential last time. Have you warmed up?
Let's be honest, Alex, it was an absolute horror show the last time from me. Yeah. So it can't get any worse, at least.
I wasn't going to say that. I was just hoping you're warmed up and you're ready to go
ready
this
to go.
Time
this
around.
This is it this time, yeah.
And Jeff, you were going for the knockout punch last time.
I failed miserably. I threw in the towel too early. It's going to be this time.
This time you're hoping to flush everyone out?
Yeah, the brain started working now. So.
OK. It's time to get cracking, everyone. First up, we need to create our leaderboard. So I'm going to ask 8 questions. The smartest and fastest will find themselves in pole position, which means banking the most cash and you're going to have the power to choose who you take on in the knockout matches. Is everyone ready?
Yeah.
There we are. Let's play. Question 1. The rules of which of these sports state that players must keep at least 1 foot on the floor when hitting the ball? Squash, volleyball, snooker, badminton. And the answer is snooker. Yes! Full house. Ooh. Question 2. The French Revolution took place in which century? 16th century, 17th century, 18th century, 19th century. OK, the answer is 18th century. 3 right, 5 wrong. We'll see how that affects the leaderboard soon. Question 3. Which of these towns is on the north coast of Wales? Llandudno, Fishguard, Aberystwyth, Swansea. And the answer is Llandudno. Kev, I thought you said you warmed up.
I was. I've got a mate that lives in Aberystwyth. I know it's in the north, but maybe not on the coast.
Okay. So. Question 4. Which of the Nobel Prize categories did Toni Morrison win in 1993? Peace, economics, literature, chemistry. And the answer is literature. Ooh, 4 right, 4 wrong. Question 5. The name of which soft blue vein cheese means sweet milk in Italian? Mozzarella, dolce latte, gorgonzola, cambazola. And the answer is dolce latte. Okay, things are heating up in here. Question 6. Which UK singer-songwriter is a featured vocalist on the top 10 hits Where Did You Go and Ready For Your Love? Emenike, Becky Hill, Craig David, Ella Henderson. And the answer is Emenike. our singer. You know I was going to come straight to you. I was thinking you'd be in the green. Let's move on. Question 7. Which of these honours holds the highest ranking? OBE, MBE, CBE, BEM? And the answer is CBE. Free, right, Molly? Guess?
Educated guess?
They were good guess at that. Question 8. The hit podcast, The Diary of a CEO, is hosted by which of the investors on Dragon's Den? Stephen Bartlett, Deborah Meaden, Tuka Suliman, Sarah Davies? And the answer is Stephen Bartlett. It's not how you start, it's how you finish. All questions complete. OK, let's have a look at the leaderboard. So at the bottom, with two correct answers, it's Paula. Val is in 7th, Kev is in 6th, Kat in 5th. Then we have a run of 5 correct answers. Jeff, Asha and Craig, which means then at the top of the table in pole position, it's Molly with 6 correct answers and a tasty looking grand, Molly. Ooh, take it in, take it in. Molly, you like it up there?
I mean, yeah, I could get used to it.
But we know what happened last time.
I
you
know.
Liked being up there, you like the
I'm gonna
cash.
I'm going for something other than eeny, meeny, miny, moe this time.
OK, we've got our rankings. And now we start our head-to-head matches on the tournament run in the ultimate quizzing tug of war. All matches last up to 2 minutes. Each correct answer pushes your opponent a step back towards the red knockout zone. Whoever pushes their opponent closest to the red zone is the winner, and they steal their opponent's money and qualify for the next round. The loser is going to be eliminated. If you push your opponent all the way into the red, just like the yellow is doing right now, you get a knockout, which earns you bragging rights and a cheeky £500 bonus. OK, Molly, you're in top spot at this very moment, so you get to pick who you're going to take on right now. Looking around, who is it going to be? Who's making eye contact with you?
Nobody wants to look at me now, but I'm going to take on Asha.
Oh, Asha is locked in. Why have you gone for Asha?
If you want to be the best, you've got to beat the best.
Brave tactics, Molly. You're going for it. Asha, how are you feeling?
Great.
Nice. Got to the final last time and bring it on. Well, Molly, you get to decide the category. You have history, music, places, science and tech, celebs and pop culture, sports and games, natural world.
I think I'm going to give sports and games a go this
time. OK. You still don't seem very confident about picking that one.
Oh, I never am, I feel more confident this time. I play a lot of sports.
What sport?
I play cricket, I play rounders, I play crown green bowls.
Oh.
Bit of everything.
OK. Asha, we know you're sporty as well.
I play a lot of games.
OK.
Not so much. I really run.
OK, this is going to be a good one. It's time for kickoff. It's Molly v. Asha in the category Sports and Games. Both look a bit nervous up there. Does it get any easier? You're used to being up there?
No.
Before we start, we need to take a look at who the favourite is. And all our players faced a pre-tournament test of their general knowledge. And based on their scores, I can reveal that the favourite in this head-to-head in sports and games is... It is Even Stevens.
I still can't get a favourite.
OK, Molly, are you ready?
Yes.
Asha, are you ready?
Yeah.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... In football, which team defeated England on penalties in the final of the men's 2020 European Championships, which were... Molly?
Italy.
Correct. Heather Knight and Tammy Beaumont have both represented... Molly?
England.
Incorrect. Thorover represented England in which team sport?
Rugby union.
Incorrect. Cricket. The four face buttons on a PlayStation controller are cross, circle, square, and which? Molly?
Triangle.
Correct. The biathlon consists of cross-country... Molly?
Skiing.
Incorrect. The rover country skiing with what other discipline?
Swimming.
Incorrect. Shooting. Wordle involves users playing four versions of which word game? Molly?
Wordle.
Correct. Usain Bolt won 8 Olympic gold medals representing which country? Molly?
Jamaica.
Correct. In what sport do two teams on ice propel granite stones towards a target? Molly?
Ice hockey.
Incorrect. They're over.
Lacrosse.
Incorrect. Curling. Which tennis player famously cried on the Duchess of Kent's shoulder when she lost the Wimbledon ladies singles final in 1993? Asher.
Steffi Graf.
Incorrect. They're over.
Sue Barker.
Incorrect. Jana Novotna. In which game do players call out grid references to try and sink their opponent's boat? Molly?
Battleship.
Correct. In a game of pool, the black ball usually has which number written on it? Molly?
8.
Correct. Supporters of which English football club are known as the Toon Army? Molly?
Newcastle United.
Correct. In the USA, the annual championship game of the National Football League is known as what? Oh, and that's time. The answer was Super Bowl. But Molly, you have done it again. You're through to the next round. Congratulations, Molly.
Thank you.
Ooh, it was a good game from you. Very strong. You do know that category.
Thank you. It's nice to know.
Well, you have come out on top. Congratulations, Molly.
Thank you.
Asha, look, you got to the final last time. That is how quickly things can change around on the tournament.
Exactly.
Well, we do have to say goodbye, Asha, this time. Thank you for being on the tournament. You've been a great contestant.
Thank you.
And Molly, once again, congratulations. You have just stolen Asha's £600, giving you a total right now of £1,600. Off to a great start again. We'll see you in the next round. Okay, it's time for our next head-to-head match, and Craig, you're second right up there on the leaderboard. So you get to pick. Who is it going to be?
It's going to be my mate, Jeff.
Oh, Jeff is locked in. That's what you do to your mates.
Yeah.
You try to take them out, Craig.
A bit of fun together, don't you?
Well, you said you like your cricket.
Yeah, sports and games is gone. I was hoping for that.
Jeff, how are you feeling? Saying your mate, but he's picked you.
He's ex-mate. Definitely ex-mate. He's cute, and he's going to get flushed away like the rest of them.
Like it, Jeff, like it. Well, Craig, what is the category going to be? You've got history, music, places, science and tech, celebs and pop culture, natural world.
I'll take the natural world, thank you,
natural
Alex.
World? Why are we going for that one?
I'm just really interested in it, you know, yeah. Love animals, love... Love the natural world. It's great to follow it a bit and see if I know anything about it.
So. Jeff, you're laughing away there.
That's the subject I would have chosen.
See,
oh, nice.
I told you he was my mate.
Well, let's see who's matey in this round, shall we? One of you's going to go home crying and empty-handed.
You get the early train, Craig.
It's time for kickoff. It's Craig v. Jeff in the category natural world. This isn't a team sport here. There can only be one winner.
Yeah. There we go.
That's all. He's got his early train on.
Early train. The fighting talk. Well, Jeff, you went out early last time.
I'm not going out early this time.
OK.
I'm here for the long run.
Craig, he means business.
Yeah, I'll let him have a go.
OK. Before we start, I can reveal that the favourite is... Craig Issue. Not thinking about that early train just yet.
Not yet, not yet.
Craig, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Jeff, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes starting in. What E describes the conservation status of the dodo? Craig?
Extinct.
Correct. The name of which marine animal comes from the Greek for eight-footed? Craig?
Octopus.
Correct. What type of tree beginning with S is typically used at... Jeff?
Sycamore.
incorrect throwover as a Christmas tree?
No.
Out of time, spruce. Beginning with R, what type of scale can be used to measure earth... Jeff?
Richter.
Correct. What word can be used to describe part of a sweet corn plant or an organ used for cray?
A husk.
Incorrect. Throwover used for hearing.
Yeah.
Correct. What word beginning with M describes the process of transformation from caterpillar to butterfly? Jeff?
Metamorphosis.
Accept. In the body, the mandible is known as the lower what? Jeff?
Jaw.
Correct. What H is the only kind of bird that is known for its ability to fly backwards? Jeff?
Hummingbird.
Correct. Hibernation usually takes place during which? Jeff?
Winter.
Correct. How many horns did the dinosaur Triceratops have? Craig?
Three.
Correct. Which letter of the alphabet is given to the most common human blood group? Jeff?
O.
Correct. What is an adult female elephant known as? Craig.
Cow.
Correct. Trumpet narcissus is a yellow spring flower. Jeff?
Daffodil.
Correct. What F is the word for the young of a deer? Jeff?
Born.
Correct. The height of a hawk, and that is a win!
Well played, mate.
Sorry, buddy.
I loved it.
Get going, you'll catch the train.
All right, yeah.
Jeff, what a round by you. You're celebrating in there because you've done it.
I didn't want to get the early train.
Craig, what can we say?
Well, you know.
All aboard.
All aboard.
Shall we say? Time to go home.
Yeah. I've packed my bags. Yeah, I'm off.
Well, Craig, thank you for being on the tournament.
It's been great. Thanks ever so much.
Thank you. Well, Jeff, keep celebrating because congratulations. You've just stolen Craig's £750, giving you a grand total of £1,150. And you through to the next round. We'll see you there. Okay, so Kat, you're next up on that leaderboard. You said you like singing.
I do.
Well, let's see if you're going to be singing when you're winning. Who are you looking to take on?
I think I'm going to take on Kev.
Oof.
Bring it.
Kev, you are locked in. Why Kev, Kat?
Because he's the next one down on the leaderboard, so I get most money from him.
Nice. What's your cash, Kev?
Fair enough. I've got a bit more to offer than I did the last show, but I feel bad because Kat's just arrived, but I'm going to be staying there at home early doors, but...
But, Kev, it decides on the category, though, doesn't it? Kat, what are you going for? History, music, places, science and tech, celebs and pop culture.
I mean, I'd be a fool not to go for music, wouldn't I, really?
Kev, musical?
Could not have been happier with the music. Yeah.
Really?
Delighted, yeah.
OK, it's time for kickoff. It's Kat v Kev in the category music. OK, Kat and Kev, the winner takes it all. Just gave you a song and you didn't even react there, both of you, because you're both in the zone. OK, let's find out who the favourite in the category music is, and I can reveal it is... Kev, it's you. You said you were confident.
Yeah, I do like my music. I guess it'll depend on the genre. Let's go.
Yeah, let's do it.
Kat, are you ready?
Yes.
Kev, are you ready?
Yes.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in. In 1966, the Beatles had a UK number one with a single about a submarine of what, Kev?
Yellow.
Correct. The single, As It Was, reached number one in the UK for which ex One Direction singer in April, Kev?
Harry Styles.
Correct. Which musical term beginning with C means several notes played at the same time as capped
chord?
Correct. What was the name of Cliff Richard's backing group who played Kev?
Shadows.
Correct. Which British singer-songwriter won 3 Brit Awards in 2022, including Best Song for Easy On Me? Kev.
Adele.
Correct. Written by Prince, the 1984 single I Feel For You was a UK number one for the US singer Shaka Who? Kat?
Khan.
Correct. Which song by The Killers has spent over 300 weeks, Kev?
Mr. Brightside.
Correct. Who won 5 Grammys at the 2022 awards, including Best Album for We, Kev?
Dua Lipa.
Incorrect. Throw over, We Are.
Pass.
John Baptiste. Complete the commonly used title of the Gilbert and Sullivan opera, HMS.
Cat. Pinafore.
Correct. Which musical instrument beginning with H is also often known as a mouth organ, Kev?
Harmonica.
Correct. Tom York rose to fame as the lead singer of which UK, Kev?
Keen.
Incorrect. Throw over, UK band.
Pass.
Radiohead. Which Greek composer wrote the soundtrack to the 1981 Oscar-winning film Chariot of Fire? Cap?
Vangelis.
Correct. The regular presenter of the Radio 2 show on Sunday that plays show tunes from... Cap?
Lane Page.
OK, you are correct, but it doesn't stop Kev from being the winner. Kev, a massive congratulations.
Thank you very much. Well done, Cap. Well played. Good game.
I like the celebration right there from you.
Thanks. It's just more relief than anything else, Alex. I didn't want to go home early again, so, yeah.
Kat, you did hit the bum note.
I did. He was quick on the buzzer.
He really was. But, Kat, thank you for being on the tournament. It wasn't to be this time. Kev, congratulations. You've just stolen Kat's £250, giving you a grand total right now of £350. Yes, you want to see that money? Well, you are through to the next round.
Thank you very much.
See you there, Kev.
Yes, well done.
It's time for our final head-to-head in this round. And Val, you're not at the bottom. We know you went home early last time. So, are you confident you can do it?
Bring it on.
Yes, bring it on. Well, your opponent over here, Paula, let's lock you in. You get to decide, Val, the category. This is the one. You have history, places, sites and tech, celebs and pop culture.
Well, I went out on history last time. Let's see if we can turn it around.
History it is. I like that you like to turn things around. That's the aim of it, Val. Paula, you feeling confident with that one?
I'm going to give it a good kick.
OK, it's time for kickoff. It's Val v Paula in the category history. It's quite the stare-off going on here. Well, you both went home at this stage last time. But it's going to be different for one of you this time around. Paula, you want to kick everyone into touch. Drop kick your opponent.
Absolutely. I reckon Val would fly over that post.
Oh!
You might break your leg trying.
Before we start, let's see who the favourite is in the category history. I can reveal it is... It's Evans.
Mm-hmm. Well matched, Val. We're well matched.
Val, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Paula, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in. The 15th century conflict between the houses of York and Lancaster is... Paula?
Tudors.
Incorrect. Throw over is commonly known as the Wars of the what?
Roses.
Correct. Barnes Wallace designed which weapon used by the RAF in Operation... Val?
Bouncing bomb.
Correct. In the Church of England in 2015, Libby Lane became the first female what? Paula?
Bishop.
Correct. What was the common surname of Emmeline, Christabel and Sylvia, the famous campaigners for votes for women? Val?
Pankhurst.
Correct. Ronald Reagan was president of the United States during which decade? Paula?
90s.
Incorrect. Throw over?
80s.
Correct. Beginning with T, what name is commonly used to describe the army of ceramic soldiers discovered... Paula?
Terracotta Army.
Correct. The leak in 2016 of more than 11 million files from the law firm Mossack Fonseca is more commonly known as the... Paula?
Wikipedia leaks.
Incorrect. Throw over as the Panama what?
WikiLeak.
Incorrect. Panama Papers.
Heard of it.
The Russian word Tsar and the German word Kaiser are both derived from what, Paula?
King.
Incorrect. Throwover. From what ancient Roman title?
Caesar.
Correct. Which country declared independence from the Kingdom of Great Britain on July 4th, 1776? Time, USA. In ancient Greek myth, what L was the prison the Minotaur was kept in? That's a time up, and it's win for Val. The answer was Labyrinth, but Val, you've done it!
Yes.
And a celebration. How does it feel for you?
Better than last time, that's for sure.
Sorry, Paula.
Well,
all right.
I'll let you take it in. You're saying sorry, Paula. It
well
was
done
a good
to
battle.
Val. Yeah, I enjoyed it better this time, so progress.
Paula, yeah. Thank you for being on the tournament.
Thank you.
Well, great. Val, things have changed around. Congratulations. You've just stolen Paula's £10, giving you a grand total of £60. You are through to the next round. Well done. OK, we are now at the semi-final stage, so let's take a quick look at how this tournament is playing out. And as it stands, in fourth, it's Val. In third, we have Kev. In second is Jeff, which means at the top of the table, in pole position right now, it's Molly. Molly, you like it up there? You've been up there before with the same amount of cash, but the interesting thing right now is, are you going to change tactics this time around? Who are you looking to take on?
I am changing tactics. I'm going to let the boys battle it out against each other, and I'm going to take on Val.
Val is locked in. OK, last time you went for someone with the most cash that you could steal. Why have you gone for Val?
I just think maybe with the categories that are left, I may have a better chance of getting one step further.
Or because she's down there and you think she's got the least and she's easiest to take out?
Maybe.
But you've made it through this time. Val, things are different.
That's right. I maybe just beat the champ. You never know.
OK, Molly, categories left for you to choose from. Places, science and tech, celebs and pop culture.
I'm going to give celebs and pop culture a go.
Any thinking behind that one?
Again, no. I'm still trying to be the favourite at something, so okay. Maybe this time round.
Val, this category?
Yuck.
Yuck. Yuck. You should give anything away. Keep that fighting spirit out, Val.
Lulling her into a false sense of security.
Like it. OK, it's time for kickoff. It's Molly v Val in the category celebs and pop culture. OK, Molly, you said you wanted to strike it rich. Does that mean you're going to go for that knockout and the cheeky £500 bonus?
Maybe, maybe. We'll see. It'll add to Val's £60.
OK, let's see who the favourite is in the category celebs and pop culture. I can reveal it is... Molly, it's you.
Finally.
You wanted to be the favourite?
It doesn't mean anything, but it's quite nice to know.
It does add more pressure on you. You should know your stuff. But, Val, you know how to turn things around.
We'll give it a go.
Molly, are you ready?
Yes.
Val, are you ready?
Ready.
2 minutes are on the clock and your time starts in. Which pop star has had world tours called Joanne World Tour and the Born This Way Ball? Molly?
Lady Gaga?
Correct. In 2019, influencer Molly Mae Haig appeared on the fifth series of which ITV, Molly?
Love Island.
Correct. In March 2020, Gal Gadot led a group of celebrities in a poorly received video where they sang which John Lennon song? Molly.
Imagine.
Correct. In April 1981, Bond girl Barbara Bach married which former member of the Beatles? Molly.
George Harrison.
Incorrect. Throwover.
Paul McCartney.
Incorrect. Ringo Starr. Which British boy band has a name that stands for Jack the Lad Swing? Out of Time, JLS. OK and Hello magazines feature what punctuation mark in their titles? Molly.
Exclamation mark.
Correct. Which British newspaper has a long-running agony aunt column called Dear Deirdre? Time, The Sun. In 2020, which British singer started hosting Friday night kitchen discos on social media along with her husband, Richard Jones? Time, Sophie Ellis-Bextor. In 2017, which actress posted a joke tweet saying happy birthday, baby, with a picture of Ryan Gosling, even though she is married to Ryan Reynolds? Time, Blake Lively. The Manchester-based social media publishing brand with over 37 million Facebook. The answer was Lad Bible. We're out of time, but we do have a winner, Molly the favourite, and you delivered, Molly. Whoop, whoop, whoop. A little silent celebration going on there. Molly, you're through to the final.
Finally. Yeah.
You got one step further than last time.
Well, hopefully two.
Hopefully two. Val, things
well,
did change around.
Well, she took on a dinosaur. It was all sort of people that I'd never heard of. So, you know, fair enough.
Well, Val, you did better than last time.
I did.
It's always a positive.
It is, yeah.
But we do have to say goodbye. Val, thank you for being on the tournament.
Thank you.
OK, Molly, well, there you have it. You are through to that final. A massive congratulations. You've stolen about £60. So that gives you a grand total, though, of £1,660 so far. You're qualified for that final. We will see you there. OK, it's time for our second semi-final. And, Jeff, you are higher placed right now, so I love
That's
the celebration.
I get to choose something.
You do get to choose. You know who your opponent is going to be. It's a battle of the boys. You're taking on Kev, so we will lock you in. Let's see what category you are going to choose. You have places, science and tech.
Places, please.
Some thought went into that. You looked over at Kev.
Santa's so our places, he might not know as many.
Kev?
I went out in places last time, but I feel quite confident still. So I reckon that Jeff's chances are going to go down the toilet now, so...
Well, you did say the last laugh would be on the opponents today,
Correct.
Kev. It's going to be a good semi-final, this one. It's time for kick-off. It's Jeff v Kev in category places. OK, you've both done better than last time. So did Val. And we've said goodbye to Val.
Goodbye to Kev now.
I'm not the one saying goodbye, but, yeah.
Nice. Fighting talk. We need to see who the favourite is in this category, which is places, and I can reveal it is... Kev, it's you.
Yeah. Like I say, it's not a bad category. I've kind of lucked out on the categories that have been chosen for me. So let's hope I make a better showing this time, then.
Jeff, how are you feeling now? You pick the category.
It was better than the other categories. He's a lot younger than me, so he's going to know a lot more tech than I do. So places, maybe. I've been to places he hasn't.
Jeff, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Kev, are you ready?
I am.
2 minutes are on the clock and your time starts in. The Globe Theatre is situated... Jeff.
Stratford-upon-Avon.
Incorrect. Thorover on the bank of which English river?
Thames.
Correct. On which continent is the South Pole located? Jeff.
Antarctica.
Correct. Which island off the coast of Africa shares its name with a 2005... Jeff.
Madagascar.
Correct. Which Scandinavian country's flag features a simple white cross on a... Kev.
Denmark.
Correct. What is the Tyneside accent commonly called? Kev.
Geordie.
Correct. What festival is famously celebrated in New Orleans on the Tuesday before... Jeff?
Mardi Gras.
Correct. Sichuan province forms part of which Asian... Kev?
China.
Correct. The National Railway Museum is located... Jeff?
York.
Correct. The hottest, driest and lowest national park in the USA... Jeff?
Arizona.
Incorrect. Throw over. USA is called what valley?
Happy.
Incorrect. Death Valley. Which seaside town in Essex is home to the longest... Kev?
Brayton.
Incorrect. Throw over. Pleasure pier in the world?
Clacton-on-Sea.
Incorrect. Southend-on-Sea. Which mountain range, beginning with P, runs... Pennies. Jeff? Correct. Lake Titicaca is situated in Bolivia and which other South American country, beginning with P? Jeff?
Peru.
Correct. In which country would you find the Shinkansen, also known as the bullet train? Kev?
Russia.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Japan.
Correct. Woking, Guildford and... Jeff?
Sorry.
Correct. The US president's country retreat in Maryland, and that's our time. The answer is Camp David, but Jeff, you are the winner. Woo! Well, you did it. You are through.
I'm into the final. I want my revenge as well. Left me out in the first round last time.
Already looking for that revenge. He's waving goodbye to you, Kev.
Fair enough. He was brilliant on that. No arguments, no complaints. He was the better man. So good luck in the final, Jeff.
Oh, Kev, well, he's had the last laugh.
He has.
He's been flushed away.
Well, Kev, thank you for being on the tournament. You've been a great contestant.
Thank you very much, Alex. Loved it. So,
thank you very much. Well, Jeff, you have stolen Kev's £350. So that gives you a grand total of £1,500 and you're qualified for the final. We'll see you then. Well, this is it, the big one. 8 quizzes are now down to just 2. A huge congratulations to Molly and to you also, Jeff. You've made it to the final. But this time, you are playing to win your own cash pot. For you, Molly, that's a grand total of £1,660. And for you, Jeff, that's a grand total of £1,500. But the loser will be going home empty-handed. So it's all to play for. Remember, though, if the winner gets a knockout, they will have a chance to double their money on the golden run. Are you both ready? OK, the category is general knowledge and it's time for kickoff in the final of the tournament. It's Molly v Jeff. This is both new for you being in the final. Molly, you said you had to take out the best to get here and you have done it. Feeling confident right now?
As confident as I've looked in all the previous rounds, which is probably not much, but I'm here. I'm happy to be here.
And Jeff, you are celebrating. Things have turned around for you today.
They're going to turn around one more time and I'll be a happy boy.
What will you do with the money, Jeff?
I'm going to buy an electric bike.
Okay.
Because I want to be able to keep up with the kids and the grandkids on their bikes.
Nice.
I can't. The old knees aren't good enough these days and they take great delight in leaving me in the middle of nowhere.
Well, let's see if you can get that bike.
I want that bike.
Molly, what will you do with the money?
I'm hoping to splash out on a green velvet corner sofa.
Oh.
Very specific.
Yeah, I feel like you already know exactly which one you want.
I haven't picked it out, but it has to be green velvet and corner.
Right. Before the final gets underway, let's see who the favourite is in the category general knowledge. I can tell you it is. It's Jeff.
Oops.
It wasn't going to be me.
You didn't want to be the favourite, Jeff?
Well, I was the favourite last time against Molly and lost, didn't I? So.
Molly, you've been the favourite once.
I'm used to being the underdog, so happy with that. It's absolutely fine.
Let's see if you are going to end up top dog. Molly, are you ready?
Yes.
Jeff, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock starting in What do the initials DIY most commonly, Jeff?
Do it yourself.
Correct. In mathematics, what is 102 times 3? Molly?
306.
Correct. Damn It, Janet and The Time Warp are songs originally from which, Molly?
The Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Correct. Typically, how many teeth does an adult human, Jeff?
32.
Correct. What word beginning with J is a large cash prize in a game, Molly?
Jackpot.
Correct. If tomorrow is a Saturday, what day was the day, Jeff?
Thursday.
Incorrect. Throw over before yesterday.
Sunday.
Incorrect. Wednesday. Which Christopher designed the current St. Paul's Cathedral? Jeff.
Christopher Wren.
Correct. Egton Bridge in Yorkshire is home to the oldest show in the world, celebrating which berry beginning with G? Molly.
Juniper.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Gooseberry.
Correct. The children's party game where players have to freeze in position. Jeff.
Statues.
Correct. Which Canadian province appears in the NATO phonetic alphabet? Jeff.
Ottawa.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Quebec.
Correct. In the nursery rhyme, Jack be nimble, what does Jack jump? Jeff.
Be quick.
Incorrect. Throw over. Jump over.
The needle.
Incorrect. Candlestick. In space travel, what type of vehicles were Discovery? Jeff?
Lunar rovers.
Incorrect. Throw over. Atlantis and Endeavour.
Module.
The answer is space shuttles. But Jeff, yes, you've done it!
What was he thinking?
Jeff, congratulations!
Thank you. Sorry,
well
Molly.
No, well done.
I was after revenge. Sorry.
Well, now it's time to go and get yourself
an
electric
bike. I'm going to get that bike. I'm off and peddling in a ditty. Can't keep up with me now.
Jeff, we absolutely love it. Molly.
Brain freeze. Like, couldn't get my words out.
Well, that's what happens on the tournament, and the pressure when you're in the final, It can get to you. But Molly, thank you so much. You've been a great contestant. Jeff, what can we say? That electric bike awaits.
It's mine.
It's all yours. Saddle up, because you've just won yourself a whopping £1,500, Jeff. A huge congratulations.
Thank you, Alex.
Woo!
Well done, Molly. Sorry, mate.
Well, can one of our players match that or do even better next time on the tournament? Remember, the tougher the battle, the sweeter the taste of victory. See you next time. Goodbye.